So we just received 5 miners today, and all of them are from Sun and Yasminer series. But we are cooperating with Jingle Mining, and we are the largest distributor of their miner in Europe. So let's do a mini unboxing. X4U1 server with 520 megahash per second hash rate to add hash to ETC hash coin and power consumption of 240 watts. What about dimension? The dimension are: the length is 48 centimeters, the width is 45 centimeters, and the height is 5 centimeters.
It looks like IDC server, but actually it's ASIC miner.
After opening the box, as you can see, we have a cable and a machine. Unfortunately, the cable was different than we use in Europe. But as always, we have a spare. But remember to have your own cable. What do you need to connect the miner? Of course, internet cable and the power cable. That's all what you need.
So let's start to connect the miner. The first will be the power cable. It's hard to insert this cable, but it worked. Then the internet cable.
As you can see, you can hear how it works. It's a low power because it's not configured, but this is the second step. Before mining, we still need to create an account on the mining pool. Can be F2Pool, or which we recommend here is a Rufflink. It's really easy to register. I hope you can do it alone. Someone can have a mining pool like me, so I just need to log in. At the top, we have to change Bitcoin to Ethereum, or you can click Ethereum Classic, what you prefer. After we have connected the Yasminer to my internet and logged into the back page, now you can set up the configuration on this page. How to find this page? You need to find your IP.
Enter the password and the login. Always it's root.
And here is the panel of the miner. Here's all information. We have status, miner, network, admin, log, upgrade, reboot, and reset. We can upgrade new firmware, for example, and overview, we have all information. Okay, let's focus on the configuration. Okay, if our miner is ready, we can write address Stratum and the worker. Worker is from pool. In the second and the third place, we can write same. And we can click here update. Then after loading, click on the second tab. It says status, and you can see uptime of hash rate. And after 30 minutes running, we can find device hash rate on status page. Here we have a green light, which is a good sign. And after 30 minutes, we have hash rate, and we will see which hash rate will be after around 24 hours. As you can see, the hash rate has stabilized and the machine is working about 500 megahash. Okay, so now let's check how loud is the device. It's around 67 decibels, so it's much quieter than a normal ASIC. After it's fully warmed up, here is the power consumption. We connect the rest of the miner and this is how they look. We can put this miner in a rack, so if we have insufficient space, we can fit our device. Here is a mini video how the rack looks like. Due to the fact that the miner is flat, we can put one on top of the other, and as you know, other ASIC model cannot be put on top of each other. So I think it's a big plus for Yasmin. That's it for this video. I hope you guys like this video. Make sure to subscribe if you are not already. And that's all from me. Bye. Don't forget about our shop. Here is the link. We are the best distributor of the miner in Europe.